According to a recent study, bacteria may have survived underground on Mars for hundreds of millions of years. According to recent findings, there may be traces of ancient Martian life somewhere out there, or perhaps they are shielded from radiation and concealed just below the Martian surface. According to Elton John's song, Mars ain't the kind of place to raise your kids. In fact, it's cold as hell. Yet recent research indicates that the planet's coolness may actually enable microorganisms to endure for up to 280 million years below the surface. The discovery gives rise to hopes that eventually signs of ancient life, or perhaps living things in suspended animation, may be discovered on the red planet, and this shocks the Tesla CEO, Elon Musk. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. According to Musk, researchers discovered that the bacterium Deinococcus radiodurans from Earth is so radiation resistant that it can withstand radiation levels that are 33 feet below the Martian surface for the equivalent of 280 million years. The tenacious small organism, which has been discovered to thrive in nuclear reactors on Earth, may even survive for 1.5 million years on the surface of Mars, despite the planet's constant exposure to cosmic and solar radiation. Mars's dry, cold environment is essential to this organism's survival. Dry ice in the higher latitudes of Mars are both minus 110.2 degrees Fahrenheit, or about minus 79 degrees Celsius. And when material is frozen to these conditions, it becomes dehydrated, and Michael Daly, a geneticist and radiation biology specialist at Uniform Services University in Maryland, observed that radiodurans become fantastically, astronomically radiation resistant. It has long been known that radiodurans is an expert at withstanding radiation. It can be found in many different areas on Earth, including the human stomach, and it has even lasted a long time in space's vacuum. The latest study, however, is the first to assess the bacterium's maximum radiation resistance when it is dehydrated. According to Daly of Live Science, researchers previously discovered that the bacterium can endure 25,000 grays of radiation when it is in a liquid culture. A human would be killed with a dose of 5 gray for comparison. Radiodurans was frozen and dried by Daly and his co-workers, which imitated cosmic radiation from outer space and solar radiation from the sun, and then irradiated the bacteria with both gamma radiation and proton radiation. They discovered that radiodurans that was frozen and dried could withstand a staggering 140,000 gray of radiation. This is equivalent to the radiation exposure from 1.5 million years on the surface of Mars and 280 million years, 33 feet below it, when radioactive decay in rocks and minerals is the only source of radiation. According to Brian Hoffman, a scientist at Northwestern University and research co-author, the organisms resist radiation in two different ways. Their genomes are duplicated in order to provide a backup for any radiation-damaged parts. Second, they store a lot of antioxidant manganese, which is used to absorb harmful radiation-induced compounds. By snatching up these molecules, the proteins that the organism uses to repair its DNA are kept safe. The proteins that carry out the repair are protected by these manganese antioxidants, according to Hoffman, who also noted that the DNA is set up to be repaired. The atmosphere on Earth shields the planet and its life from the worst radiation where radiodurans first appeared. The bacterium likely evolved to withstand damage during dry periods, and the radiation resistance is just a side effect of that evolution, according to Daly. Any Martian bacteria would have had to evolve in an environment without that protection and likely would have had to evolve similar radiation resistance. Even if ancient life did evolve on Mars, 280 million years is still too short to suggest that the planet is home to an abundance of bacteria just waiting to resurge into life. This is because Mars has not had widespread liquid water for 2 billion years, even if ancient life did evolve there. The planet's surface is frequently hit by meteorites, though, because of Mars's thin atmosphere, according to Musk. Those impacts may have the potential to stir up dormant bacteria in the subsurface and trigger a reflourishing of life because of the heat and liquid water released. The long-lasting potential of bacteria on Mars means that remnants of ancient life may still be present as residues in the rocks, even if this brief oasis notion is incorrect, according to Hoffman. Even though the organisms that were long dead, DNA and other signs of life may still persist in shards. According to the study's authors, the results also have implications for guarding against the contamination of Mars by germs from Earth. NED Radiodurans would probably make it from Earth to Mars if they boarded a Mars rover. Researchers discovered that other microbes, including Escherichia coli and several Bacillus species, may also survive for thousands of years on the Martian surface if dried and desiccated. According to John Rummel, a senior scientist at the SETI Institute and a former planetary protection officer for NASA, it will be crucial to prevent Earth microbes from being unintentionally transported to Mars and mistaken for extraterrestrial life as more missions aim to bring samples back from Mars to Earth. Rummel handled the journal Astrobiology's editing of the new study, even though he was not involved in it. Rummel declared, "Here, the round-trip tourist organism is an issue, and we need to be careful about how we handle that." On the other hand, when journalists, photographers, and television camera crews barged into NASA's Washington, D.C. headquarters on August 7, 1996, they turned their attention away from the scientists seated in the row in front of them and toward a little, clear plastic box that was on the table. A velvet pillow was placed inside the box, and a rock from Mars was placed on top of the pillow like a crown jewel. When they discovered indications of life inside the meteorite, the scientists made an announcement. "It was an unbelievable day," gushed NASA Administrator Daniel Golden. Came as a shock to himself, he was more precise. According to the researchers, the rock formed on Mars 4.5 billion years ago and remained there until it was propelled into space 16 million years ago, most likely as a result of an asteroid impact. Up to 13,000 years ago, the rock traveled the inner solar system before falling to Antarctica. Before 1984, when snowmobiling geologists picked it up, it was resting on the ice close to Allen Hills. The rock, known as ALH-84001, had an unusual chemical composition, according to researchers led by David McKay of the Johnson Space Center in Houston. It contained a mixture of minerals and carbon molecules, which are made by bacteria on Earth. Additionally, it included magnetite crystals, which are magnetic iron oxide crystals made by certain bacteria. In addition, McKay showed the audience an electron microscope image of the rock that revealed chains of globules that were strikingly similar to chains that some bacteria generate on Earth. Although the data wasn't absolute proof of previous Martian life, McKay said it was pointing in that direction and added, "We feel that these are certainly microfossils from Mars." There are many other objectives besides looking for evidence of life on Mars. That tells you something, according to Musk. If you discover a habitable environment but no sign of life, if there isn't any life, why isn't there life? The first is what makes Earth's abundance of life so exceptional, and the answer raises other questions. The effort being put forth to find early life on Mars may ultimately prove to be the most valuable right here on Earth. And that ends today's episode. We certainly hope you enjoyed our video. So what do you think of these latest Mars findings? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below, and please subscribe and don't forget to like today's video. You can press that bell icon and you'll be notified of our latest uploads right away. Thanks for watching once again, and we'll see you next time. Have a great day.